Hey, I found some pretty good inflatable videos on Facebook. Let's check them out.
I'm Rich Havistol.
Wow, guys, check out that Spider-Man on the wall.
We call it Havistol's Holiday Inflatables on Jay.
Been doing it for, I think, 16 years. When I was a kid, we used to always go around and look at everybody else's lights, but we never did anything. So when we got a house, I decided that we were gonna start doing something.
We never had inflatables when I was a kid, so I always wanted to put tons of them in my house. Those signs would bother me big time. I'm glad I don't have those in front of my house.
DJ Bell and his family spend thousands of dollars to put up Christmas decorations every year.
Yikes, when they say it like that, it's like, oh no, let's just not talk about that, okay? Also, they shouldn't charge so much for them. And look at that cute puppy!
Well, this year, they say someone stole two inflatables, a Lightning McQueen and Matter.
One that noticed it first was my three-year-old son noticed it and immediately started crying and wondering where they were, and it's so hard to explain to him what had happened to him.
So I don't get the point of this. Did they resell them? Do they put them up their house? I mean, somebody will notice that you don't have those before. I don't know, people are so mean.
DJ says he nails down each inflatable with a couple of stakes to even make sure they're secure.
Also, when they took it out, the power adapter that goes with them, they forgot to take that.
Look at his smile. Only inflatable enthusiasts know that they messed up.
So not only did they steal our inflatables, but they're completely useless for them.
Paula Geib says last year her laser lights were stolen, so she took steps this year to make sure that doesn't happen again.
Is this like a bad neighborhood where they keep stealing stuff from their yards?
So this year, we fixed that. Thanks to our neighbors, they donated some lights to us too, that they had extras. But this year, he mounted them up on the top of our flagpoles, so they can't be stolen this year.
That's pretty smart. Do you have any tips to help people not get their stuff stolen?
These neighbors say they put up displays to bring holiday cheer to the community, and it's sad someone would try to ruin that.
Everybody should be kind to each other, help each other, and that's what we do it for. We do it to bring joy and happiness to those that can't have it.
I just don't want the Grinch to steal Christmas, so I just keep on plugging away at it and keep putting it up, and we just hope it never happens again.
He has a really good attitude. I think I would be very angry about it. So check this house out, guys. These people have some super cute inflatables, a lot of animated ones. Look at the way the yard looks, it's crazy. So it says that they have 145 inflatables, which is super impressive. They also have them separated by theme, so it looks really cool. Oh, look at that Elsa, I don't like that Elsa. But anyway, look at how cute, look at the, I don't have any of Ninja Turtles, but this 32-foot Santa, that's insane. Where they got it, who knows, because I've never seen this, maybe they got a special order. But this thing, it's gigantic, and it has like giant sandbags in the feet to make sure that it doesn't fly away, but look at it. Look at that, it's insanely enormous, but that's pretty cool. I've never seen an inflatable that big in real life. Hey, check out the Paw Patrol back there. Pretty impressive, you have to admit.
I started about 9 years ago, and I went out and bought four or five, and I thought I had a really nice display, and then the OCD kicked in, and each year I just added more.
Hey, comment down below if you can relate to this comment. I know I can. Okay, so they say this house has 200 inflatables. I love Halloween inflatables. They look awesome. Check that one out with the ghosts inside. Oh, who can relate to this? Who's got this going on at their house? I know I do. I know it's hard to figure out where to store all this stuff. But look at how epic it looks. I mean, you only live once. Why not make the most of it? It's an expensive hobby, but it is a very fun hobby.
Yeah, we'll start this side on Tuesday. Monday, we'll place everything where they go. Tuesday will be this side. Pumpkin patch. Big Frankenstein, big cat, the big purple guy. And then Wednesday and Thursday, we'll do this whole side, minus the little guys in the front. Little guys in the front will be done next week. Probably start that the 19th. Because I'm not doing anything on a weekend. I'm going to sleep on the weekends.
If you've never put up a bunch of inflatables, just know it takes forever. It takes forever. So he's got some pretty unique pieces, like that Frankenstein you just saw. And that tree is pretty cool. I like it. They also give candies to the kids in the neighborhood. You know, I get sad because we don't have that many trick-or-treaters that come here. We always end up with a lot of leftover candy. Ooh, that's that jack one I wanted. It looks so cool. And this is like a flyby, or a drive-by, should I say, of the same inflatable setup. But check it out. It's like it goes on forever. I love it. It looks awesome. And they have a lot of space to put them up, too. When you don't have any space to put them up, it kind of, like, you're limited. But they look like they have a lot of space all the way around the block. So they're very blessed for that. This is another video I found on Facebook. And you can see that they have a pretty good sized inflatable collection as well. They have, you know, not really any themes, but look at that fireplace one. I think I saw that one at Home Depot, but I can't remember. And the Elsa one, I don't like it. I think it's lazy. But anyway, the variety is great. And if you check out that mirror ball, look at it. It's so cool. And this mixer, I've never seen one like that. I've never seen it. Comment down below if you know where they sell that. But yeah, they have an awesome, impressive collection. And even something like this would take you forever to set up. Ooh, I have that fire truck. Aaron got that as a birthday gift. I don't have any patriotic Santa inflatables, I don't think. And look at the tractor. And then there's a ladder. Nice, they did a good job. I saw this one also and I wanted to share it. I don't think I saw this one before, but check it out. It's epic. If you don't know, that's the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man from the movie Ghostbusters Part 2. And you can see tentacles coming out of the building. I don't think that's a part of the movie, but it still looks really cool. I wonder who they got to do this, because this has to be a custom job. It looks awesome. This is like a restaurant somewhere. I'm loving these drone shots. These drone shots look really cool. I don't have a drone, so I've never gotten drone shots of my inflatables. Not that they're on the roof or anything. I wonder if you can see that Stay Puft guy, like, from when you're walking on the sidewalk. Or you think that you just got to cross the street to see it? I wonder. Oh, I wanted that Angry Bird inflatable. Can't find it anywhere, and it's super expensive on eBay. This is another video that I found on Facebook. Now, it's not like a news, you know, report, but I wanted to show you these cool inflatables they have on their yard. So, that one back there said student driver. Oh, look at Santa Claus's long camouflage. Maybe you didn't see him because of that. And then there's a rocket one back there. They have them really close to the house. Check out that rainbow Christmas tree. That, I hadn't seen it before. I only saw it this year. And you could see there, like, archways and other kinds of things. I mean, I don't know why they haven't pushed all the way back. I guess because they're afraid people are going to, like, mess with them. And then there's a Merry Christmas, like a bunch of candles all in a row. Overall, a great setup. They have plenty of room to expand. So this is another house that has a bunch of inflatables. It's a time lapse of the inflatables inflating, you know, but I do think that it takes forever. But anyway, look at Snoopy on the motorcycle there. He popped up right away. Did you see that? And then you have these other bigger ones. I guess it's a driveway. I'm not sure. I don't really have to deal with snow that much, so I don't know. And then there's Mickey up front. He's pretty big. I wonder how big he is. And then there's Darth Vader. You could see him coming up. And oh, wait, this is a repeat because that Snoopy had already gone up. But yeah, so this dog is up by itself already. And I think it's a castle. Yeah, look, did you see the castle pop up? And then you have Bumble there. Woo, woo, he's getting blown around. And look, it's that dinosaur one back there opening the presents. I really wanted that one. I didn't get it. And there he is with his lightsaber. And look at this swimming pool one. It's like they're gonna go swimming. That's funny. And they have this big Santa over there by the house. I wonder how big that one is, because it doesn't give any information about this house. It doesn't give any information about what inflatables they have or anything, or how many they have. But it still looks pretty cool. Look at that. That's like a animated mini there on the left. That's pretty cool. And then finally, Bumble is up. I wonder if that's the It's probably that giant one that was at home. I think it was like 20 feet. But yeah, I really want to get bigger ones this year, so hopefully I'm able to. I just don't know where they're going to fit in my yard. It worries me. If you made it this far in the video, comment Santa so I know how awesome you are. Let me know what you thought of these videos. I hope you have a great day. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you later. Bye!